Hi, I'm Bruce Brown. Slippery When Wet was my first film. It was 1958. I was lifeguarding in San Clemente and working nights at Dale Velzy's surfboard shop, gluing up balsa blanks and sweeping the shop. Dale and I talked all summer about making a surf film. I'd make it, he'd pay for it. We finally settled on the budget, which would be $5,000. That would include the cameras, lenses, tripod, all the film, air travel to Hawaii, and my living expenses till the film was complete. We recruited five surfers and hopped on a plane for Hawaii in September. They had their boards, and I had my new camera and my book on how to make movies. I still have it. Found it in the attic. We came back from Hawaii in December, and I spent the next few months editing film. When the film was sort of edited, I decided it needed some music. So I went up to the lighthouse in Hermosa Beach, California, where Bud Shank was playing. I asked Bud if he'd like to do the music for the film. He said he'd never done music for a film. I said, that's okay, I've never done a film. He said, perfect. I gave him the whole music budget, $250. We couldn't afford a recording studio, so we recorded it in the offices of World Pacific Records, which was one small room. I sat out in the hall, shined the projector through the mail slot in the door onto the wall. The quartet sat inside and played the music. The most traumatic thing that happened was I realized the film had to be narrated and I would have to do it. I'd never spoken before a group of more than three people in my life. Just happened to run across the old narration, fortunately, in the attic. It's an old quarter-inch tape. This is what you'll be hearing. Instead of using the standard newsreel approach of the time, I decided I wanted to tell a story, basically about five surfers on their dream trip to Hawaii, which in 1958 was a pretty exotic trip. The story starts literally in the beginning. My son Dana, who helped me put these old films back together, said it's one thing to tell a story, but you didn't have to start at the dawn of mankind. Hey, I was 20 years old. It was 1958, it was my first film, and this is the way it was.
In the beginning, there was the sun. Nothing but the sun moving through the heavens. The sun took strange colors and the winds blew. Covering the surface of the earth were seas. Seas were turmoil. Then all was calm. Strange gases rose from the surface of the sea. One day a small ripple appeared. Ripples formed into tiny waves that were too weak to even break. And at last, foam appeared on the surface of the sea. The waves began to take definite shapes and roll restlessly shoreward. Time went by, the waves grew larger and threw their foam on endless beaches. Storms were born far out to sea, pushing the ocean into frothing, seething, giant waves that exploded on the shore. Other waves came with their crests tumbling tons of water into their troughs, and the perpetual foam rolling ever shoreward.
With civilization, there came the surfer with his urge to conquer these moving walls of water.
Thank you.
The whole story began in San Clemente, California. It was late summer 1958. Dale Velzy was arriving as usual at his surfboard shop. Dale went through the tedious morning ritual of opening his shop for business. The mailman arrived with the usual stack of morning bills. This morning was a rare exception for Dale, though, because in with his pile of bills was a letter from a friend in Hawaii with a couple of surfing pictures enclosed. I think the pictures triggered the whole trip when Dell Cannon drove up in his estate wagon. Dell managed to wrench the door open and noticed the pictures that Dale was thumbing through. Dell had been to Hawaii once before, so he had his own definite thoughts of the islands. These pictures set him to thinking, daydreaming. Mind's eye began working overtime.